On today's Minute of the Apes, bleep bloop, my ship is doing something I didn't tell it to do.
Hello and welcome to Minute of the Apes, the daily podcast where we break down every minute of the Planet of the Apes movies, 1 minute at a time. I'm Todd. Sean's breaking into his Grogu...
Tamagotchi.
Well, I could not get that word in my head. Tamagotchi. And Richard is just standing there as effervescent as always. How are we today?
All right.
Are we excited about this? Here we are.
Hey, we're 1 minute closer to the end.
You know, I apologized a lot when we would knock.
Quit apologizing.
No. It's funny because the other films when we did them, I was apologizing because I felt like we were being harsh on them, that we enjoyed them.
Yeah.
But we were harsh because it was almost. I think our admonishment was of the studio for cutting budgets and all this. You've got this thing that's working. You want to make more of it. What they forged, what they created, was so cool. What they made with this thing. I wonder if those studio executives are still in the business, because somebody should have said, you need to go away.
Stop.
So, minute 107. I know Sean's taking out the instructions for
Grogu.
I'm saving
this for the in-between.
Okay. Sean, please tell us what's happening with minute 107.
Right, we're going to start minute 107 with Davidson giving Pericles to Ari and end with Ari saying, one day they'll tell a story.
All right. Ari.
Yeah.
Minute of the Apes. Planet of the Apes. Minute 107.
Take good care of him, okay?
Yeah. Well, I can promise you I won't put him in a cage.
Let's find the coordinates of the stone that brought me here.
You know, it would mean a great deal to everyone if he would stay. It would mean a great deal to me.
I have to leave now. I have to take a chance that he can get me back.
Yeah. You know, one day they'll tell a story.
As of minute 107, we have an Oberon's worth of apes and humans, two displaced pods worth of humans and apes, so many wild humans in Ape City, minus two gorillas, and a peace among humans and apes.
Visually, we get the wide shot. Ari's looking down at her buried compadre as Leo walks up with Pericles, hands it off to her. They go over the shoulder a little bit. They're standing in what looks like a rock quarry. Limbo comes in and doesn't really touch anything, as best I can tell, and everything goes beep boop, so alarm. Leo runs over to the pod. The kid, looking at Leo run away, Leo comes to the pod, checks some things out for what look like star charts as Ari walks up behind him. He turns back to her. They have another over the shoulder, a tense moment, cuts in a little bit closer.
I'm wondering, remember we were talking about Pericles earlier and stunt actors and whatever? Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if this is the scene where he attacked Helena Bonham Carter.
I don't know.
Whenever she's holding him.
So I'm immediately bothered in this moment. He hands off Pericles and says, take good care of him, okay? He's not.
That's just saying, I'm fucking off right now.
Yeah, and he's never said, I'm leaving. Yet then if you fast forward up to after he runs to the pod... And
she puts down Pericles and comes right back over.
And she says to him, he says, the coordinates of the storm that brought me here, that whole thing, right? Mm-hmm. And then he begins to say that he has to leave.
I mean, what is his plan?
But why is he not announcing he has to leave before he hands off Pericles? Because when he gets Pericles, if I'm her, go, why? You can stay and take care of him. She should ask that question.
Yeah.
He's not said I'm leaving. Has he?
He is not, but it the assumption with the landing of the pod is that it's going to, but it also only seats one person. Like yeah. There's got to be a little more here for this. The ship finding something would be his indication that he's got to go. Right, that would be the I cannot stay here. Mm-hmm. I've got to go. I need to pass off Pericles onto you.
Mm-hmm. But what is his plan? I mean, his station has crashed. He's in the future, so is he just going to fly back to Earth? I mean,
and why does he think that cloud is going to do something?
From what
he can't get back to Earth, as far as we know, with this.
Well, yeah, from what we've seen, that cloud shunts you into the future. So if he jumps into it, he's just going to go further into the future. Maybe.
Its internal logic is screwy. But the weirdness too, I wish it would stay, it would mean a lot to me. All these things, once again, the sexual,
which we never got any build up on that, yeah.
I don't get it. I don't get why they care about each other other than that they've had quiet moments that have tried to say they do. There's not a lot that happens in this minute, and this may be finally the one, you know, Richard had predicted there'd be short minutes. I think this one could be, because again, it's hand off the monkey, Limbo makes some noises, Leo runs over and says, I gotta go. And
well, why was she over on the left and he has to run to the ship to the right, and then he's back on the left now and she's on the right?
Well, to be fair, they don't cross screen directions. They flip it.
Because if you look, you see her in the background still, and then she puts down Pericles and comes over to him. So, like, the whole point of him handing it off, she, like, dumps him off as fast as she can, too.
He ran in one direction, and then it doesn't matter.
It's goofy, and all of it's... Man, I can't even find anything to break apart in it, because nothing happens.
Well, we know that he's now going back in the cloud.
Yeah,
we know that he's leaving his monkey behind.
Yeah,
we really know that he's going back in the clown.
Yeah,
right. And you know, and someday they're going to tell a story.
Like someday they can tell the story right now. Everybody sees what's going on.
Right.
Why doesn't he admonish Limbo? Limbo goes over and that doesn't touch anything, and alarms go off. Yeah. That's the best we can. The
big boop is a coincidence. Coincidink.
Why doesn't he turn and say, "Get away from that"? Wouldn't you?
I should. Or what did you touch?
Right. Don't. Yeah, what did you touch? Don't
nothing.
Touch
nothing. It did it on its own.
Yeah. Characters have to act and react to the environment and what's given to them. And it's, once again, cut Limbo. Cut him.
I'm just annoyed the movie has just ended. Like, the movie's just ended.
Also,
and it's a weak ending, you said.
Ari made a big assumption. I mean, Davidson made a big assumption that Ari would take care of Pericles.
Right.
I mean, he just handed her either a child or a pet without her consent, either way.
He showed, so Richard called out, and I agree with him, they showed humanity in the last moment when he picked up Pericles, was caring about him, and even treated Limbo with a little bit of respect. Hey, I understand where you're hiding.
But then he dumped Pericles as fast.
But then he's the worst parent in the world going, hey, you take care of him.
Right. You're kidding. I'm so glad you're alive. Goodbye.
You're kidding now. Bye.
And also, you've seen it before in 1,000 movies. Why didn't he kneel down to his child?
And try to talk and say, hey buddy, I'm glad you came here, but I've got to go.
I've got to go. You know that I can't stay, and I've also got to...
I got to see if I can fix this.
Why does he? What is it he has to fix?
Well, I mean, does he think he's going to go back in time and stop himself from going out there, or stop Pericles from going? I don't know what his plan is.
And is it the solar flares and all that kind of stuff? And I don't fucking know. I don't get why he feels he has to leave, because that pod, they alluded to that they were short distance pods or something like that at the first of it. That is not a deep space vehicle.
His ship is gone.
Yeah.
He's
gonna fly back into a storm that could potentially kill him in the hopes of going back in time.
Back in time, forward in time.
Do you know why he leaves? Because we need to get Thade into the weird future that somehow changes.
What ending are you talking about?
Whatever.
I don't know.
Fuck this. I can't
finish it.
We needed him to give us some exposition on what he's trying to do, where he's trying to go, why he needs to leave,
right,
so that we have some sense of the fact that he's just not, I'm just going to get in the spaceship and see what the fuck happens.
Characters often have to explain themselves like that so we emotionally can latch onto it. And there's nothing. And once again, Leo is given nothing that makes me give two shits about him. Sean's now looking at his phone.
I'm done with this minute. Let's go.
All right.
Oh, how long do we talk about this minute? Not even 10 minutes.
No, 9 minutes, 46
seconds.
Not even
10 minutes.
Wow, not even 10 minutes? We haven't even talked for 10 whole minutes.
Does anybody
slowly getting closer and closer.
Does anybody even care about the fact that the ship is just suddenly fighting the storm? Like, there was no reason for the ship to go, hey, I found the storm, dude. We need it. You know, if he had...
If whenever Pericles if had Limbo arrived, had, programmed it to say, where did you come from or something?
Let him walk over with Pericles. Pericles, hop in for a second, do something.
Right.
Allowing this, I don't know. I just
so bad. All right. That's it. Sorry. I call this one done. We officially went 10 and a half minutes. I think that is our threshold. We have to at least finish.
Poor audience this week is like, hey, we did 11 minutes.
We did it. Well, they don't have to suffer either. So there you go.
Again, we get to those next movies. I'm not saying they're perfect. I'm not saying we won't find
flaws.
But
I can already think of what I know my first major flaw is with the first movie, and it happens within the first 20 minutes.
And there are flaws, but still, I can think of the emotional subtext between the James Franco character and why he's creating what he's creating. Mm-hmm. That's beautiful, and it's beautifully done, and it's handled beautifully. And I can't wait to actually be gleeful again about, hey, they did this, and I wish they missed an opportunity, but this is so good. This is so bad.
Yeah.
That it's, I don't even know. This is not a scene where you look at it and you go, I could simply fix this scene with that. You would have to go back and do 40 pages of rewrites to make this scene work with a few other changes. It's just terrible. Okay, that's it. Minute 107. It's just terrible.
It's horrible.
Everyone have a great day.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.